I was looking at reports around the Bulldog and the Union Jack. Bulldog was used in the late 70s for propaganda. It was for racism. However, it did initiate this music scene which brought black people and white people together. It was a mix of rock and reggae. And it led to the modern image of Britain, which is integration of many cultures, and that is how I experienced UK. So I've redefined it by taking Bulldog and integrating it with felting, embroideries, and various laser cutting techniques. So I'm basically redefining Bulldog and the Union Jack.
Thank you,
Manny.
Moving on to Steve. Can you please tell us a little about your collection and your inspiration behind it?
Our collection is Nature Square. We've been inspired by an artist called Joseph Olbers, homages to Square, and our complete collection is a knitted collection. We have used different techniques of knits. We have woven, we have printed, and in that we have taken a common camo theme with a touch of color, and our clothes are more wearable for the Indian men. And most of this which we have used is knits. Thank you so much.
Could you tell us how you feel in this outfit and what was it like to walk the ramp
for you? You know, I started my career as a model. So if you're asking me how did it feel great. It felt great that I was back on the ramp. I met all my old friends and I was working for a designer who's made a young, quirky collection. So it's what I'm wearing, what I like about this is that it's very wearable and it's at the same time very unique. It stands out without trying too hard to stand out. So that's what I like about the collection. It's very comfortable. And Piyush is a dear friend and he said, ki, let's do this together. I'm like, anything for you, man. So this is for him. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Moving on to Tanya.
Yeah, my turn.
Tanya, could you tell us about your collection and the inspiration behind it?
My collection is called Memory Folds. It basically talks about the minds of women today has evolved over the years. Women today, we're confident, we're working and we play with our roles. I'm not just talking about working women, because for me working means not only you're on a job, talks about even homemakers, but time has changed where women of today feel that she needs to give time to herself, she needs to style herself, she needs to have some time for herself, apart from her busy routine with home, kids, with your business, your work, your profession. We like to spend time with our friends, go out with our husbands. Women of today spend likes to dress up. And not only cosmopolitan, you see other cities also. And my collection here is very strong, oriented, and we have a collection inspired by women of today. We have day look and evening look, which you saw on the show. And we have excellent showstoppers. So Reen was a great example to present my theme, which is when she was right news and for the memory poll.
Thank you so much, Tanya. Over to you, Sylvie.
Yeah. Well, I think it feels absolutely wonderful to be stopping the show for Tanya today. As she's very rightly said that, you know, when she gave me the garment and I was, you know, she'd come home for trials and we tried the outfit and I just suddenly just exuded so much strength and so much power. I think what it really brings out is the other side of the species woman, which is of course as a whole it's a blend of the right balance of the soft, the subtle, the elegant, and then the other side which Tanya today wanted to really really bring out, and she's brought it out with absolute extravagance and with beauty. So I think this is something that every woman of today would enjoy wearing and enjoy carrying off. Of course, confidence from within, and when there's something like this to sort of carry it with it, just makes it a double whammy. So I thank you, Tanya, for having me do this today, this evening, and I think all of you will really really look forward to this selection. I'm absolutely in love with it.
Thank you, Sarveen. That was well said. Do you have any questions?
And I want to ask Manish Kansal a question, that how is it that the line was so very winter and that you had a slight inclination towards the winter?
I mean, if you think about the Union Jack, you think about the UK, it is quite a poor country, and if you think of, again, the colour palette as well, I've taken a deeper colour palette, and being at Winter Festive, it was sort of an automatic thing that I had to use wool, and the London Carton tailoring has always been core to the label, so I think going for wool fabrics was just an automatic choice. Thank you.
May I request all of you to just step in front for a photo?
Sure.